Hey, what's up, and thanks for watching TopKlass Tutorials. In this video, I'm going to share some of my favorite ProTools shortcuts to help you speed up your workflow. This video was requested by Bollywood Remix FLP, so shoutouts to Bollywood. He's got some cool Hindi EDM-style beats that he makes in FL Studio, and you can download the projects also, so go check them out and show your support. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. Let's get started. So I remember when I first started working in Pro Tools, and I thought I was really good until I did my internship at MusicHouse Studio I in Atlanta. And I got the opportunity to work with some really amazing engineers and producers. And I noticed that most of them use shortcuts, especially when tracking and recording vocals. So I spent a couple years perfecting my craft and learning those shortcuts, and it's helped me tremendously. Most of the artists I work with come to me because I'm fast and efficient, and they like that I can keep up with their pace. So hopefully these shortcuts help you also. There are tons of shortcuts in Pro Tools, and most of the ones I'll be showing are geared towards recording and mixing, but if you have a specific question or request, leave it in the comments below. So I have a blank Pro Tools session open, and I'm going to make sure keyboard focus is turned on. You can turn keyboard focus on or off by clicking the A to Z button at the top right corner of the edit window. Also, I'm using a Mac computer, but most of these shortcuts are the same for Windows. Just remember to use Control instead of Command. First thing I'm going to do is create some new tracks for recording. I'll press Command, Shift, and N to bring up the New Tracks window. With the window open, I'll press Command, Up or Down arrow to change the track type. Next, I'll press Command, Left or Right arrow to change the track width. To add more tracks, press Command plus on the numeric keypad. If you don't have a numeric keypad, you'll have to click the plus icon next to the track. You can also remove tracks by pressing Command and the minus key on the numeric keypad. Now I'm going to name my tracks. I'll double-click the nameplate, name my track, then press Command right arrow to go to the next consecutive track and rename it. You can press Command left arrow to go back to the previous track. There are several ways to increase your track height in Pro Tools, but my favorite is to select the tracks I want to change and then press Control, up or down arrow. I can also hold down Option and click the ruler area next to the track to change all of the tracks, or Shift and Option to change selected tracks. I can also hold down Option and click and drag between the tracks to change all of the tracks, and Shift Option to change selected tracks. Now I'm going to start routing and assigning inputs for my aux tracks. I'll start by holding Command and selecting the first aux track to deselect it, and then click the track again to select it. Then, while holding down Shift, I'll click on the last aux track to select all of my tracks between my first and last selection. Now I'll press and hold Command, Option, and Shift, then change my input of my first aux track to bus 1 and 2, and it will cascade the inputs of my aux tracks to the next available bus assignment. Now, I'll rename the inputs to their respective tracks by right-clicking on the input and selecting Rename. Let's say I want to add the same plugin to all my aux tracks. Instead of inserting the plugin one track at a time, I can select all of my tracks, press and hold down Option and Shift, and add a plugin. Now, all the selected tracks have the same plugin. Once I have everything set up how I like, I need to import my music. I'll press Command, Shift, and I to bring up my import audio window, find my music, double-click the track, and press Enter. Now I need to get my audio track ready for recording. Now select my audio track and press Shift M to mute, Shift R to record arm, and Shift I to activate input monitoring. I can also press Shift S to solo a track. Now I'm ready to start recording. There are several different ways to record in Pro Tools. My favorite is to press 3 on the numeric keypad to start, then press 0 on the numeric keypad to stop. You can also press F12 to start recording and spacebar to stop recording. You can also press Command and Spacebar to start recording, and Spacebar to stop recording. To use Command Spacebar or F12 to start recording, you may have to make some changes in your system preferences. Start by clicking the Apple icon in the top left corner of your screen, select System Preferences, then select Keyboard. Under the Keyboard tab, check the box next to Use F Keys for Standard Functions. Then under the Shortcuts tab, go to Spotlight and uncheck Show Spotlight Search. What I often see many artists and engineers do when recording is they have a template with tracks labeled lead vocal 1, 2, 3, vocal double 1, 2, 3, ad lib 1, 2, 3, etc. And they will record on the track and then unarm the track and start on a new track to start recording. There's nothing wrong with this method, I just don't prefer to do it this way. Instead, I'll have one audio track dedicated for recording and then duplicate that track when I'm finished recording and move the audio region down. If I record a lead vocal for an artist and they want to double it, I'll press Shift Option D to duplicate the track, type how many tracks I want to duplicate, and then select only inserts and sends and press OK. Then I'll hold down Control while dragging the audio clip to prevent it from moving left or right down to the next track. Let's say I want to fix a specific part or section and I want to give myself enough time to get ready after I press record. I can do this by selecting the area I want to record, then place my cursor where I want to start playback, and while holding down Option, click in the edit window. Now I have 4 bars of pre-roll before the recording starts. I can also hold down Option and click in the edit window where I want playback to stop, which is known as post-roll. I can enable and disable pre and post roll by pressing Command and K. If you're having trouble seeing your waveforms, you can increase your waveform height by pressing Command, Option, left or right bracket. Note that this doesn't change the volume of your audio, it only changes the size of the waveforms. To zoom in horizontally, you can press Command and left bracket or right bracket, or press R or T. If you want to separate an audio clip, you can press Command and E, or press B to separate audio clips. To fix separated clips, select the area where the clips are separated and press Command and H to heal the clips. When working in Pro Tools, there are 5 different modes to use: Shuffle, Slip, Spot, Grid, and Relative Grid. To cycle between the different modes, you can press the tilde or acute key, or press Option 1 for Shuffle, Option 2 for Slip, Option 3 for Spot, and Option 4 for Grid, and Option 4 again for Relative Grid. I primarily use Slip and Relative Grid mode. Slip mode allows you to place your cursor, make selections, and move audio freely from the grid or tempo values. Grid will snap your selection to the grid value selected and snap the beginning of your selection to the grid line. While in grid mode, if you hold down Command while making a selection, you will temporarily be able to make selections and move clips freely from the grid. Relative grid allows you to move audio clips based off their relative position to the grid lines and won't snap the beginning of your selection to the grid. This is very helpful when arranging vocals and working on music. ProTools also has different tools that have specific functions, and they all have individual keyboard shortcuts. The zoom tool, which is self-explanatory, is command 1. The trim tool, which allows you to adjust the length of clips, is command 2. The selection tool, which is also self-explanatory, is command 3. The grabber tool, which allows you to grab audio clips and move them, is command 4. The scrubber tool, which allows you to solo and scrub through selected audio clips, is command 5. And the pencil tool, which is mainly used for automation, is command 6. There's also a smart tool, which is what I use 90% of the time, that you can activate by clicking the bar above the three tools or pressing command 7. This allows me to cycle between these three tools based off where I have my mouse hovering over an audio clip. For example, if I move my mouse to the beginning of an audio clip, I get the trim tool. If I move my mouse to the bottom of a clip, I get the grabber tool. And in the middle, I get my selection tool. Sometimes I'll use just the selection tool to make it easier to quickly make selections or remove unwanted space from my audio clips. A quick way to remove dead space from audio clips is to press Command and U to open my strip silence window and press strip to remove silence. I can trim the beginning of an audio clip to my cursor by pressing A. I can also trim the end of an audio clip to my cursor by pressing S. To create a fade from the beginning of a clip to the cursor, I can press D. And to create a fade from the end of a clip to my cursor, I can press G. I can create crossfades between two audio clips by selecting a region and pressing F or Command F to bring up my fade window. I can create multiple fades by selecting a region with multiple clips and press Command F to bring up my batch fade window. It's very common for me to copy sections of a song to another place, such as a chorus or repeating sections. While in grid mode, I'll make a selection and press Command C to copy audio, and then press Command V to paste the audio. I can also make a selection and press Command D to duplicate sections, which is very useful for flying hooks and choruses to the correct time of the music. To mute and unmute audio clips, I can press Command and M. If you accidentally delete something or make a change, you can press Command Z to undo most everything in Pro Tools. This doesn't include inserting plugins or assigning inputs and outputs. Now I'm going to work on some mixing shortcuts and go to my mix window by pressing Command and Equal. If you have a lot of tracks and you want to make them smaller, you can press Command, Option, and M to narrow tracks and press it again to go back to the default size. To copy plugins to other tracks, hold down Option and click and drag the plugin to your desired track. To bypass or mute a plugin, you can hold down Command and click the plugin and it will turn blue. To unbypass, Command click the plugin again. If you want to bypass all the plugins at once, select your track and press Shift and 2 and press again to unbypass. You can also bypass multiple plugins in the same slot with the selected tracks by pressing and holding Command, Option, and Shift and clicking the plugin. To bypass all the plugins on the selected tracks, simply press Shift and 2. If you have plugins that use a lot of CPU or cause latency, you can deactivate the plugin by pressing Command and Control and clicking the plugin. You can disable multiple plugins on selected tracks by holding down Shift, Command, Option, and Control and clicking the plugin. If you want to open up multiple plugins, press and hold Shift when opening the plugin. If you have too many plugins open, you can press Command, Option, Control, and W to close all plugin windows, and press again to reopen the plugins. I like to use groups when editing and mixing. First, select the tracks and press Command and G to bring up your group window. Name your group and press OK. Now I can select all of my tracks at the same time, and any changes I make will be applied to those tracks. To temporarily bypass the group when adjusting the volume, you can hold Control and move a fader. You can activate and deactivate all groups by pressing Command, Shift, and G. I love to use automation in Pro Tools and especially with EQ to create filter sweeps and transitions. To activate automation in a plugin, hold down Command, Control, Option, and click the parameter you want to automate, then select Enable Automation. Next, on your track, click the Automation tab and select your automation parameter and create some automation. You can press the minus key to go back to the waveform view. You can also press the minus key to view your volume automation. A quick way to go to your automation is enable automation and then hold Command and Control and click the parameter and it will automatically be displayed in the edit window. ProTools can sometimes crash during sessions, so I try to save my work as frequently as possible by pressing Command and S. I can also save different versions of a song by pressing Command, Control, and S to bring up my Save As window. There are tons of keyboard shortcuts in ProTools, and these are just some of the many I use when recording, editing, and mixing music. If there's a shortcut I didn't mention that you want to know about, please leave a comment below. Also, if you're interested in having your song recorded, mixed, or mastered, please send an email to topklassent@gmail.com or visit the website in the description section below. I hope you found this video helpful, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Until next time.